entrepreneurship programs, economic development, a water workforce program, score mentors, and more. Welcome to Weekly Wire Roundup number 8. I'm your host, Barry Smith III. This video newsletter is a wrap-up of articles, news, and events around the Inland Empire and part of StartempireWire.com, an aggregate location on the web dedicated to connecting you with the best startups, people, and events in the Inland Empire. Subscribe to our channel on YouTube and join our email list at StartempireWire.com. Now the news. The first article that we reported on was four Inland Empire universities betting big time on their entrepreneurship programs. Those programs are in the following universities: Cal State University San Bernardino, who launched their entrepreneurship program 2 years ago and also has a master's of science in innovation and entrepreneurship program that they run at their college. The second university would be UCR, University of California, Riverside. UCR made a dedicated program called the Entrepreneurial Proof of Concept and Innovation Center, or EPIC. EPIC delivers experiential entrepreneurial education. They deliver individualized mentorship and access to capital to promising students, startup founders, and startups. EPIC is closely related with Excite Riverside. The third school that we reported on was the California State Polytechnic University, or Cal Poly Pomona. Basically, they banked $1 million in federal funding for the development of an entrepreneurial and social hub for startups in the Inland Empire. And the fourth one we mentioned in the article is the University of Laverne, who initiated the Randall Lewis Center for Entrepreneurship, Innovation, and Social Impact in Ontario. And I believe they are closely working with the fourth sector innovation startup incubator over there. So the second article we reported on this week was JBS gets a $1 million grant to develop water workforce program in the Inland Empire. So you might want to check that article out. Basically, the Jewish Vocational Services secured $1 million in funding from the Department of Education. The group onboarded the Inland Empire Utilities Agency to develop workforce for the Inland Empire water infrastructure. The aim of the program is to provide paid on-the-job training to interns that will increase the knowledge and expertise required for Inland Empire's future water leaders. The IE Works program offers up to 10 intern positions in IEUA annually. The reason why IEUA and other organizations like JBS are pushing forward to train water workforce in the Inland Empire is that the region's 41% of IEUA employees will be eligible for retirement by 2025. Check that article out on the website. You can research a little bit more about it and go to some of the supporting articles that we cited as well. The third article we reported on this week was Riverside County's Office of Economic Development. So we just wanted to let people know a little bit more about the county's Office of Economic Development, which actually is a great resource for entrepreneurs and startups. So the County of Riverside's Office of Economic Development, or OED, offers support to grow or expand businesses in the County of Riverside. The OED especially pays attention to financing support options available via partner organizations. Candidates include electricity, intensive businesses sensitive to electricity rates and businesses that would relocate outside of California or cease operations, but for the incentives afforded under Southern California Edison's EDR program, which we may talk about further in a future article. The OED of Riverside County also holds events such as those related to manufacturing or business functions like branding strategies or startups. The fourth article that we reported on this week was the University of Laverne opening a business school in Ontario, California. So you can check out this article on the website as well. The gist of it is this. University of Laverne is set to open the Randall Lewis Center for Entrepreneurship as it obtained a gist of $2 million from real estate executive and philanthropist Randall Lewis. It's basically an exchange or swap of properties between the City Council of Ontario and the university, hence the near zero lease amount of $1. Laverne University is one among the four top universities of the Inland Empire region, innovating and spending millions to set up their entrepreneurship programs. At the start, the university might seek a $5 million economic development grant from the state, along with tapping other investors. Get more details on this article on the website. The fifth article that we put on the website was Six Reasons Why SCORE is the Hidden Gem for Startup Mentorship in the Inland Empire. And here we're just listing out those top six reasons. If you check out the article, they include these points. Number one, finding mentors as easy as putting in your zip code and letting the system surface mentors active in your area. So you can go to the SCORE website and get these resources directly from their website, put in your zip code, and get connected with someone locally. The second reason why is that the resource library that they have has templates regarding 12 business areas and functions that you can use. Lots of good free knowledge there. Third reason that we cited was the workshops offered by SCORE are comprehensive and by segment, entrepreneur type, and business area you want to learn something from. And one of the fifth points we talked about was Small Business Resilience Hub offers, number one, remote mentoring, resilience training, resource, and a resource portal to help you find the specific information, resources, and financial support that you need. So check out those resources on our website, and then really it's pointing you to the SCORE website because they are the hidden gem for entrepreneurship here in the Inland Empire. I have personally been mentored by SCORE for several business reasons, and they've been a very good resource. Check it out and get some of that great knowledge. The sixth article that we wrote about on the website was five innovative companies in the Inland Empire to inspire your next startup. So here on the inspiration tip, we just wanted to mention again some of these companies that you should probably look further into for more inspiration. First one, our first two, Esri and Barnes, basically are part of $3 billion companies from the Inland Empire. They're two companies who are banking in more than $1 billion per year. I mean, Stater Brothers was listed in that list as well, but we didn't put them in this list. Perceptics. Perceptics is an employee surveys and people analytics company. It's a company which, you know, it's a little bit more hidden, but you need to check them out, Perceptics. And Plant Prefab, they are here in the Inland Empire. They didn't originate in the Inland Empire, but Plant Prefab basically is construction tech startup that nabbed a $30 million fund, I think it was Series A, in MedTrainer. They operate a healthcare-focused compliance management and automation software company. Great companies to research and get more inspiration from. Dig into these companies. We'll mention more in our further art, our future articles on the website, but this is a great start. And now for the events. So upcoming meetups and meetings this week include, number one, the Inland Empire Bitcoin Happy Hour. It's happening again October 25th. If you have never checked them out, their meetup group is meeting in Redlands. It's a great opportunity for you to meet, collab, and talk with other fellow people who are interested in Bitcoin. And the second meetup would be Techo Tuesday Tech Meetup, which is happening Tuesday, October 26th. And Techo Tuesday is meeting at a new location in Corona this month. And it is a new co-working spot. And I will be there. And quite a few other people will be there as well. So check it out. And finally, we get to our conferences and festivals. As we mentioned for the last several weeks, the Riverside Angel Summit continues until November the 3rd. And this week on October 25th, they have a workshop called Due Diligence Essentials of a Roadmap. And they will also be taking a deep dive into the finalists. So on October 25th, that's when that's happening. And on also on October 25th, the investors are doing due diligence on the finalists that day as well. And the second upcoming event will be Future Fest, which we've mentioned before. Tickets are still on sale. Early bird tickets are still on sale. You want to check those tickets out, and they are purchasable on the website. The website is ftrfst.com. Go ahead and join the mailing list to stay updated. And we look forward to seeing you at Future Fest as well. If you can make it to any of those events, or if you have any other event ideas for me, send your event ideas to info@startempirewire.com. We would love to put your event in the broadcast, and we hope to hear from you guys soon. See you next week. Peace.